Let's talk about least squares fitting of other curves. So this means curves other than lines. So this is going to build on some of the ideas of least squares fitting of lines or linear regression. So if you haven't watched that video, go watch that one first. So let's take a look at an example. So suppose I'm given these data points in R2, and suppose I want to find a curve that fits this, a least squares fit, using a curve of the form y equals beta naught plus beta 1x plus beta 2x squared. Right, so the linear algebra way maybe of phrasing this is I'm looking in the subspace generated by 1x and x squared, and I'm looking at all of these quadratic polynomials, and I want to find the one that best matches the given data. So what would the ideal relationship be? Well, if I had a quadratic polynomial and its graph went through the point x1, y1, I would need beta naught plus beta 1, x1 plus beta 2, x1 squared to equal y1. Similarly, if it went through the point x2, y2, I'd have beta naught plus beta 1, x2 plus beta 2, x2 squared equals y2, and so on for all the rest of the points. Right, and let's draw this picture from the previous slide. If you look at this picture and you think about it, the curve that we found doesn't actually go through all of the points, which means this linear system that we wrote down is inconsistent. And just as before, we don't want to just throw our hands up and say we can't solve this problem. We want to find the best possible quadratic that we can. Right, and so that involves finding a least squares solution. So here's our linear system again, our ideal linear system. The coefficient matrix of this linear system is called the design matrix. It has as its first column 1, 1 all the way down. Right? These are the coefficients on the beta naught unknown. The second column is x1, x2, all the way up to xn. These are the x-coordinates of the data points that we were given, and these are the coefficients on the beta 1 unknown. And finally, the third column of the matrix is x1 squared, x2 squared, all the way up to xn squared. These are the squares of the x-coordinates of the data points we're given. These are the coefficients that are on the beta 2 unknown. So this is called the design matrix. We have, again, our observation vector, y, which is y1 up to yn. These are the y-coordinates of the data points that we're given. And in this case, our parameter vector, beta, is beta naught, beta 1, beta 2. This is the vector of unknowns that we're going to try to solve for, find a least square solution for. So we're trying to find a least square solution to the matrix equation x times beta equals y. So remember what that means. It means we're trying to solve the normal equation x transpose x beta equals x transpose y. Right? So if you want a refresher on this, you can pause the video and go watch the other video on finding least square solutions. What does this involve doing? Well, we need to compute x transpose x, we need to compute x transpose y, we set up the augmented matrix, and we row reduce and solve. And then by the best approximation theorem, we're finding the best possible solution for beta, right? It's best in the least squares sense. So this technique generalizes. What would it look like in the general case? Suppose we're trying to fit a bunch of data points by a curve of the form y equals beta naught f naught x plus beta 1 f 1 x plus all the way up to beta k f k x. And so in linear algebra terms, we're looking in the subspace generated by f naught f 1 all the way up to f k, and we're trying to find the curve in that subspace that best approximates our data. So we need to find a least squares solution to the linear system beta naught f naught x1 plus all the way up to beta k, fk x1 equals y1, right? This is the equation you would get if the curve went through the point x1, y1, and so on for all of our points. So down to beta naught f naught xn plus up to beta k fk xn equals yn. So this would be some massive linear system with n equations, k plus 1 unknowns, right, beta naught up to beta k, that we're going to try to find a least square solution to. So just as before, let's try to break this down. We want the coefficient matrix of this linear system. So this is again called a design matrix. It's going to have as first column f naught evaluated at the x coordinates of the data points we're given. So it's f naught of x1, f naught of x2, all the way to f naught of xn, right? So these are just the coefficients on the beta naught unknown in the linear system. The second column will be the analogous thing using the function f1, right? So it'd be f1 evaluated at all of the x coordinates. And finally, the last column is the last function fk evaluated at the x coordinates. So this design matrix, that's just the coefficient matrix of this linear system. We have an observation vector y. These are the y coordinates of the given data points, y1 up to yn. And as before, we have this parameter vector. These are the unknowns that we're trying to solve for. This beta vector is beta naught up to beta k. And so we're trying to find a least square solution to the matrix equation x beta equals y. Again, that means we're trying to solve the normal equation x transpose x beta equals x transpose y. We can do this by computing x transpose y, setting up the augmented matrix, row reducing, and solve. So let me make a quick remark here. There's a notion that statisticians introduce, this notion of a residual vector you might read about. This vector epsilon is y minus x times beta. And so if you just solve for y here, this is saying that y equals x beta plus epsilon. And so the idea is we want to try to minimize the length of this residual vector, minimize the length of epsilon. But that's exactly what we're doing when we're trying to find a least square solution to the matrix equation y equals x beta. Right? We're minimizing the length of the difference. So let's at least look at the setup for an explicit example. I won't go through the actual matrix computations, but I'll break it down so that we can see what each of the components are. So suppose we're given data points 1, 7.9, 2, 5.4, and 3, -0.9. And we want a least squares fit by a function of the form y equals a cosine x plus b sine x. Right, and so what we're doing is we're looking in this two-dimensional space of functions generated by cosine x and sine x for the curve that best matches our data, best in a least square sense. Right, so what do? We need the coefficient matrix of the linear system that we're looking for. So the first column of this design matrix X is cosine 1, cosine 2, cosine 3. Right? I'm looking at that. I get that because cosine is the first basis vector of this space that we're looking at. I'm evaluating that at the points, the X coordinates of the data we're given. So I'm evaluating that at 1, 2, and 3. The second column is sine 1, sine 2, sine 3. Again, I'm looking at the form of the curve that we're looking at. Its second component is a sine x function, and so I'm evaluating that function at the x coordinates of the data points. And that's our design matrix. Our observation vector y is 7.9, 5.4, negative 0.9, and that's looking at the y coordinates of the data points we're given. Our parameter vector beta is the parameter vector is the vector of unknowns. That's the a, b in this case. Beta equals a, b. And so if we include the residual vector, we're looking to minimize the length of the residual vector epsilon in the equation y equals x beta plus epsilon. Right? And so remember, this is the same as finding the least square solution to the equation y equals x beta, where x is our design matrix, y is our observation vector, and beta is our parameter vector. So what would that involve? That involves solving the normal equation, solving x transpose x beta equals x transpose y. And so if you wanted to complete this exercise, you would compute x transpose times x, you would compute x transpose times y, and you would row reduce that system and solve. And so notice the columns of x, if you compute x, you'll see that the columns of x are linearly independent. Right? There's two columns, and neither one is a scalar multiple of the other. And so what that tells us from the previous section is the columns of x are linearly independent, which means there's going to be a unique least square solution. And so there's going to be a unique a and b that is the least square solution to this equation, which means there's a unique curve y equals a cosine x plus b sine x that best matches this data.